So in this video, we're going to talk about an example of electrochemistry problem solving, where we're given a reaction that is used to power a pacemaker. So this reaction involves the oxidation of metallic zinc, which is in the elemental zero oxidation state, to 2+ when paired with oxide in the form of zinc oxide. And so zinc is being oxidized from 0 to 2+. And mercury oxide, where mercury is +2, oxygen is -2. Mercury is being reduced to its elemental liquid form, where it's 0 in oxidation state. So this reaction is spontaneous as written, or E cell is 1.35 volts. And we're asked to determine the amount in kilograms of mercury oxide that would be consumed if we have to operate the pacemaker for 1 year, or 365 days, and it's using 0.01 watts as power. So, of course, we can relate the standard potential of the reaction to the free energy change. And the reason we want to find that free energy change in joules is because that's going to tell us about the amount of energy that's released by each mole of mercury oxide. Now, the reason we need joules is because we have 0.01 watts, and watts are a power or an energy expenditure per unit time. Watt is a joule per second. So that's where this time is going to come from. So first I'm going to find the standard free energy change. Okay, we know that delta G standard is equal to the negative moles of electrons transferred multiplied by Faraday's constant multiplied by E standard. So the only unknown currently is the number of moles of electrons here. And since zinc is going from 0 to 2+, or mercury is going from 2 to 0, you can say that zinc donates 2 electrons or mercury accepts 2 electrons, but N is equal to 2 for this reaction. And 96,485 joules per mole volt is Faraday's constant. And then multiplying by the standard potential we're given of 1.35 volts will give the free energy change. Of course, this negative 2 is in 2 moles of electrons. So delta G standard here is -260,510. That's joules. And this is per 1 mole of mercury oxide, right? So we're given that there's an understood coefficient of 1 in front of mercury oxide. So that's why I can say that 2 moles of electrons are transferred for 1 mole of mercury oxide. And I want to get the final answer in kilograms of mercury oxide. So that's why I'm going to list this as per 1 mole. Okay. So now it's simply a unit conversion where we're going to think about the amount of energy expended per second, which comes from the power. And then we're going to relate that to the number of joules needed, and thus the kilograms of mercury per hour, per day, and then per year. So we know that 1 mole of mercury oxide can be used to expend 260,510 joules. Okay. And this negative sign here can be dropped because we know that the energy is being released. And that's what's allowing for the pacemaker to function, is that energy released. And we can simply multiply this first to cancel joules. So we know that it's using 0.01 watts or 0.01 joules for 1 second. And that will give us moles of mercury oxide consumed per second that the pacemaker functions. And now we simply need to convert and get it in terms of kilograms per 365 days or per year. So we can first start to convert from seconds to minutes to hours to days. So there are 60 seconds in 1 minute. And of course, there are 60 minutes in 1 hour. And then there are 24 hours in 1 day. And finally, 365 days in 1 year. So now we know the amount of moles of mercury oxide per year. And I'll just show you how these cancel out. Joules cancel when we multiply by the wattage. Seconds cancel. Minutes do as well. Hours. And now days. So then we can simply convert from moles to grams and then to kilograms, given the molar mass. So 1 mole of mercury oxide is 216.59 grams. So now finally, we can see that the moles cancel and the last conversion to do is now to divide by 1,000 grams, which are in 1 kilogram. And our final answer here, we'll have grams cancel and we'll have kilograms per year, or the amount of kilograms of mercury oxide occupied or consumed, I should say, in 365 days. So I'm just going to multiply all these through to get our final answer. So the final answer is 0.262 kilograms of mercury oxide that are occupied or consumed in 1 year. So this is a problem that simply requires you to understand the meaning of some of these different mathematical parameters, first knowing the definition of a watt, which is joule per second, that relates to the free energy that's being released. So you must calculate that joule value first. And fundamentally, you should must know that that's the amount of joules released per the balanced reaction, which involves 1 mole right here with an understood coefficient of 1 for mercury oxide. After that, you can simply convert to kilograms by canceling out seconds, minutes, hours, days to give kilograms per year. So for more practice with electrochemistry problem solving and dimensional analysis like this, you can visit either Unit 4 of my analytical course guide, that's the electrochemistry section, or you can visit the electrochemistry unit in the general chem course guide, both of which are available at chemguides.com.